Hey, how's it going guys? Ray here. In this video, we are comparing between the S7 Edge, which is now recording this video,
and the Note 5. Alright, so it's a long-term review, as I've been using the Note 5 since it was launched last year. The S7 Edge, I got it through pre-order, so I've experienced them for quite a long while. Again, I've changed the arrangement of this review by giving a clear conclusion at the beginning of this video. The Note 5 is still a great phone to have, from the design, performance, camera, and the display. It also has an S Pen inside the phone. It is still an all-round, top-notch smartphone even in 2016, but the S7 Edge is better in every aspect. The design is more refined, the chipset under the hood is much more powerful, and the camera is truly outstanding under low-light situation. Back to the design, yes, they look similar to each other, but small details are improved on the S7 Edge. Like the chamfered edges now meet the glass panels much smoother than before, and thanks to the overall rounder design and a slightly curved back. Not only does the S7 Edge provide a smoother touch than the S6 Edge last year, but the Note 5 as well. The camera hump is now reduced to just 0.8mm. Meanwhile, they added IP68 water and dust resistance and a huge 3600mAh battery. At the comeback of the microSD card slot, it is definitely a more refined, more mature product. Mind you, the class and the speed of your card could heavily affect the performance of your phone. Some say Samsung didn't allow formatting the microSD card to the system is a shame. But in fact, if you want to get more out of the powerful S7 Edge, even the Class 10 U3 card I'm holding, the speed is much slower than the UFS 2.0 ROM they've used. Speaking of the performance, the S7 Edge smokes the Note 5 literally on every benchmarking apps. Stay tuned for the comparison between the Snapdragon 820 and the Exynos 8890 on the S7 Edge. Yes, the S7 Edge is a much more powerful device, but the Note 5 is still running buttery smooth. Apps opening is just milliseconds behind. But we have to wait for the Android 6.0.1 update on the Note 5, which is now running on the S7 Edge. Facebook scrolling is also much smoother on the S7 Edge, and it opens large apps and games a lot quicker. So the upgrade does exist, but may be marginal for normal users, especially if you won't push it hard at all. The camera is a huge upgrade on papers. Yes, it does shoot smaller 12-megapixel pictures compared to 16-megapixel on its predecessor. But with a larger 1/2.5-inch sensor and a larger f1.7 aperture, more light can enter those larger pixels. Low-light performance is a game-changer. For daytime shooting, the major differences are the color saturation and the white balance. The good news is the S7 Edge still shoots crisp photos as the Note 5, with higher color saturation and overall more lively. During the nighttime, the S7 Edge clearly outperforms the Note 5. Details are sharper and the colors are more vibrant. Still, the difference may not be huge, but it is better. And thanks to the larger pixel, larger aperture, and the larger sensor, the S7 Edge shoots much brighter and clearer videos in low-light environments. We also get 240fps, 720p slow-motion capability on the S7 Edge, and hyperlapse. It is not outdated on the software side either. All the Samsung TouchWiz functions including multi-window, floating windows, one-handed operation and theming are here. But we've got the S Pen on the Note 5. Screen-off memo which allows instant note-taking is handy. Smart Select is also a better way to crop a specific area of a screenshot. The S7 Edge, on the other hand, makes a good use of the Edge display. Switching between apps is slightly more convenient using Apps Edge. Task Edge is a new panel which allows entering a specific function of an app. Quick Tools packs compass, ruler and torch, and somehow is the most practical use of the Edge display. You can even download more panels and expand the functionality further on the setting menu. The newly added Game Launcher makes screen recording possible. You can also turn on Do Not Disturb and disable the capacitive keys when gaming. Move on to the display. Samsung has been making the best displays on their smartphones for years now. Both the Note 5 and the S7 Edge packs a Quad HD Super AMOLED display. But if the slightly dimmer edges and the color shifting on the edges of the display matter to you, the Note 5 has a better display. The speaker, on the other hand, they both feature a single speaker on the bottom edge of the device. The Note 5 is slightly louder and sounds crisper, but the S7 Edge is richer in the bass. We also get similar audio output on either of them. Ultra-high quality upscaler is available on both devices. Finally is the battery life test. The 3600mAh battery inside the S7 Edge gives 25% better battery life compared to the Note 5. One day of mid to high usage is not a problem. So a better, more refined design, better performance, better camera and longer battery life. But the Note 5 is still not far behind. If you're a Note 5 user, is it worth upgrading to the S7 Edge? Well, it really depends.